Saturday. It's a beautiful day. And today, I hope all my viewers and all my subscribers are doing well and keeping safe. I'm going to be sharing my recipe with you guys for smoked herring. And guys, it's a very, very nice and easy, simple way how to make smoked herring. So you guys will never regret this way that I'm going to be showing you guys. Smoked herring is such a comforting, beautiful dish that sometimes we think twice to cook it or make it because of the time and the bones and everything that you have to do for the preparation. And it's something that I like to once in a while to have as a beautiful, comforting meal. So I want to share my version of how I make smoked herring in a very, very easy and simple way. So guys, this is the smoked herring fillet. You can sometimes find them with the skins, the whole fish. But if you can get the fillet, it's actually easier to work with because you don't have to peel off head and skin and all that. So this is what it looks like. They already peel it off from the skin and everything and cut it up. And there's lots of bone in herring. So what I like to do, I like to, when I take out the amount that I'm using, because this is a lot, I like to put them in some plain water to wash off all the necessary salt that's on it. So I will do so. I'm just going to take half this amount and cook half of it this time. And then I'll cook another half another time, because when I make smoked herring, I usually cook it with other things. Not only smoked herring, like I'll make dal and rice and smoked herring, because it goes really nice with dal. And I like to put another, like a vegetable or something when I'm making this. So I think this is the amount I'm gonna be using today. Let's do that, because I love smoked herring. And so I'm gonna do this, like rinse it off, and then I will put it into hot water to boil out more of the salt that's infused into the fish, because they put quite a lot of salt to preserve this fish. And you don't want to cook it with all the salt. So I'm going to boil it. And another thing, when you boil it, the bones will start showing up. And there's a lot of them in here. So many times, like, we love smoked herring. But, and I'm sure a lot of you can relate to that. Because of all the bones, you don't want to take that extra time to, you know, pick out bones and all the time it's going to take to prepare this dish. But guys, I found out a very simple way how to do this. So I'll share that with you guys, that something that I never used to do for years and years. And just because I love smoked herring, I used to be sitting down for hours to pull out bones. But I'll show you guys a simple way. So I'm going to take you guys over. So guys, you have to let the water boil, and you're not putting any salt or anything into there. So I'm going to put the fish. Now I already rinsed it in my in some water. And now I'm going to boil it a little for all the salt that's in the flesh of the fish to come out. So we're not cooking a salty, salty smoked herring. But guys, smoked herring is so delicious. It is so, so delicious that once you find an easy, simple way how to do it, you will love to make this as much as you can. For me, I can eat it once a week. Or what you can do, you can make a big batch and freeze a little bit, like freeze them in little portion, and then you can use it when you make dal or something like that. But the most, the way that I use it the most is with when I'm cooking dal and rice and smoked herring with some other vegetable. So I'm gonna let it cook here for like 20 minutes, and then I'll show you guys the next step. Guys, this is about 25 to half an hour now. So if you look here, you can see the oil of the fish is just floating on the top. But I'm going to take it off now and let it cool off. I'm going to strain it out from the water because the water will be salty. And then I'll strain it off and let it cool before I start working with it, because I don't want to get, I don't want my hands to get burned. So I'll strain it out from the water and I'll show you guys the next step. So guys, these are the ingredients, the seasoning actually I'm going to be using for the smoked herring. I have 3 green onion, wash and clean. I have here a whole onion, wash and peel. And I have over here some peppers. This pepper I had grown in my garden last year. So I'm going to use a piece of this. And here I have 2 wirrie pepper. I'm going to be using all two of these and piece of the big one, because the red and the yellowish greenish have different flavors. So it's gonna be very nice, because those of you who love and know of smoked herring, you have to put a lot of pepper in there. And here, guys, I'm gonna add one tomato. I'm gonna cut it into small pieces, and I'll cut everything up, and then I'll show you guys how we put it together. So guys, I just want to show you guys, it's nice and cold now, and this end here, if you look, Jesse, I don't know if you can see it. Look right here, there is a lot, yes, a lot of bone on this end here. So what you want to do, and that's a harder kind of bone, if you look here, you can see there is some softer bone here. So these ones, I used to sit down for hours and hours and pick these out, but I find a way now how to do that. You just want to take out these harder ones at the end of the, it takes a little bit of time to do, but not like when you have to sit and pick the whole bone. If you look at this, this is a harder bone, and you don't want that to go in your mouth when you're eating. So even though it's smoked herring fillet, herring is full of bone, but the flavor, the smoky flavor of it is so delicious. So you just want to pull out these big ones from here, from right from the end, and then I'll show you guys how to do an easy way with the other soft bone, because the soft bone I don't like either to see in my plate, and that's why I used to sit down for hours and hours and take every single grain. By the time I finish, I used to be so tired just to get a little bit of smoked herring out of when I finish peeling it. But those are the ones you want to look for to take out, like all the hard bones. Some of them don't have it, and some of them do, so you won't be like, this one don't have it. So just look for those ones and then take them out. And if you buy the whole smoked herring, then you'll have to take the skin out, and then in the middle will have a big middle bone that you have to take out, and then you can split it, and all the bones that there will show up in the ones with the skin. But for the bone, the fillets, these ones is pretty simple, because you don't have to take that much bone out. So guys, I'm gonna show you guys now how I prepare this to get the rest of the bone out and make this very delicious and tasty. I have here all my cut up ingredients, chopped up very finely, from pepper to onion to green onion and tomatoes. And we're gonna put this up into this smoked herring and have a delicious finish after. Hours and hours to take out. You're gonna be so happy that you learned this new way of doing it, and that now even if you think twice to make smoked herring, you will now do it in no time. So what I usually do, I put it in a NutriBullet or a blender, magic bullet, whatever you have in your kitchen, and I'm certainly sure everybody have one. You just break them up, just show how you break them up into small pieces, and you just put them into your whatever it is, NutriBullet, magic bullet, blender, whatever, and then it turns
like this,
and then it's gonna come out like that, which all the bones is crushed and gone, and you will never see the bone in your smoked herring, which will make you so happy. And this you can do in like 2 minutes or so. Quickly, the quickest you can ever make a smoked herring. Guys, I want to share this with you guys, because when I, like before in the past, when I want to eat my smoked herring, and I guess I said that so many times, I would sit down for hours, my husband would help, whoever is visiting me that day, they will help. And guys, at the end of it, it's just a little bit you get out of it. And I find with when I do this, it comes out fluffier. Show them, Jess.
Here.
Fluffier it comes out. Just don't do that. It comes out fluffier, and it's, you get more out of it when you blend it up. So I'm gonna show you guys how I do this one, and I hope this was very helpful today for all my friends who really love smoked herring. So I'm just gonna go ahead and it's too noisy, guys. So let me finish, and I'll show you guys when I open it up. Look how it is. Let me just show them here, Jess. That's how it is. It came out with no bones, like you guys can see, and so fluffy. One and two bone might get in there, but you can just hand pick them out. And guys, this will make your life way much better. For all my smoked herring friends and lovers, I have to do back the bottom set, because it still didn't finish yet. So we are gonna show you guys when we're done all of it. Show you how much we got because it became so fluffy after you put it in the blender and there's no bones. You can sit down and eat this comfortably without any bones. So what I'm gonna do, I have some 2 tablespoons of coconut oil in the pan. I'm gonna put all the smoked herring into the pan. I'm not waiting for it to get hot, and look how fluffy that is, guys. Oh my god, this is so fluffy and it is so, this smells so delicious. A nice smokiness from the smoked herring. My mouth is drooling. I just can't wait to have this. So guys, you just want to turn it up a little in the oil, and I can hear it start sizzling. You will find 1 and 2 of the soft bones still escape in between, but that's fine. You can always pick them out, or those ones are edible, like the very 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 soft one. Those ones sometimes get past the blending process, but that's fine. So what I want to do now, because I already passed it here into the oil, I'm gonna add my tomatoes, because I want the tomatoes to lose some of that water from after it get heated. And in this, you don't have to add any salt, because you remember smoked herring had lots and lots of salt inside. And this is that tomato that I cut up, and I cut them into very very small slices so I can get this all over in the dish. Guys, look how beautiful that's looking. And I always like my smoked herring with a lot of tomatoes and onions and pepper for sure. So we're gonna let this turn up, and this tomato is gonna lose some water, which will help the smoked herring to be nice and moist. And I don't want to put the seasoning to cook out. I want the seasoning to be, have a nice crunch when I finish cooking the smoked herring. So I'm gonna let this go for like 2 minutes so the tomatoes can get a little bit softened, and then I'll show you guys the next step. Guys, I am turning it back now after that 2 minutes, but if you notice there is, it's like catching to the bottom of the pan, you just remove it, and you can add a little bit of water because we don't want it to be dry. You want it to be nice and moist, so you can add a little pinch of water, like a teaspoon or two of water. And then at this point here, I'm gonna add in all the rest of the seasoning. So I'm gonna go in with my onions, and I'm gonna go in with the green onions because I don't want them to cook out and get too soft. I wanna still feel the bite onto the onion and the green onion. And I add my pepper, and you guys can see how much pepper I add. So look how beautiful that is, guys. This feels like if you wanna eat it right away. Guys, and the smell is amazing. I just love the smell of smoked herring. And when I make smoked herring, I'm so excited, guys. Look how beautiful this is. So those of you who love onion, you're gonna love this dish. And for all my friends who don't like to chew onion, there's another way that you can do this. You can always grate the onion into the dish. So if you don't like to chew on the onion, or you don't like to see the onion into the dish, just grate it. Or leave it out if it's something that you really can't have. Leave the onion out and just add more green onions, because that's gonna help to flavor it up as nice too. But guys, I'm gonna cook this up about 1 or 2 minutes, and then I'll come back and show you guys. It's ready, it's almost ready here. 2 minute cooking is all done and ready. And like I said, if you find it's catching to the bottom and it's not right now, add a little bit of water to keep it moist, because you don't want it to be dry, you just want it to be moist. So I did add a little pinch more of water. And guys, depends on how much you're making, so I don't want to give a measurement for the water. Depends on how much you're making, you're gonna adjust your water to make it moist for you. But guys, trust me, tell me, you guys leave me in the comments, and let me know if you don't think you're gonna be making smoked herring now, because how simple and easy this way was. So guys, I hope I inspire some people to make smoked herring this coming week or sometime soon, because for me, since I learned this way, I just want to make it every once a month because it's something now that I look forward to because I don't have to spend much time on it. So I'm going to plate and let you guys see. Usually when I make smoked herring, we would eat it with dal and rice and smoked herring. And I like to put another vegetable or something on the side. So I made some spinach and dal, but I already have a recipe for how to make dal on my channel. I never did one before for spinach, but that will come soon. And here is the smoked herring I have. So today I'm gonna be having my dal and rice smoked herring. And guys, I just want to taste and let you guys know the favorite part of the day, not only to make the dish but to eat the dish and taste it. So,
that's my favorite part.
I know. So I'm going to mix in, and I put a lot of pepper here, guys. So I am just going to be careful when I'm tasting that I don't put a big chunk of pepper in my mouth. So cheers to all my viewers and all my subscribers. Guys, sometimes I feel like I really want to share what I make with you guys, but the most I can do is taste for everyone. So cheers, guys, and I'll let you guys know. Oh my God, I am so happy right now. This tastes so good. That smoky flavor of the smoked herring. I bite into a piece of the onion and the tomatoes and everything. Guys, you will never ever, if you haven't tried smoked herring before, guys, please try it. You can also eat this with fried bake. But guys, this is such a comforting Saturday dinner or lunch or what you want to call it, a weekend, but you will enjoy it. So guys, hope you guys like the step that I did. I tried to make it as simple as I could and share my easy way of making it by using the blender or the magic bullet or whatever you have in your kitchen. And trust me, you'll cut the time into half, the preparation time into half. So you guys have a wonderful, wonderful Saturday afternoon with your family. And you will hear from me on my next video. And all those who haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. You only have to subscribe one of the videos. If you like this recipe, please give me a thumbs up. Until then, bye for now.